this problem came from the integrated algebra exam, which most people are still going to take in June, the end of June. Some of you might take it in January. So here's the problem. It says solve the following systems of equations. Systems means there's at least two. Algebraically, that means you cannot graph it, you can't draw a picture, you actually have to do the mathematics. And for all values of x and y. So we have y is equal to x squared plus 2x minus 8, and then y is also equal to 2x plus 1. I tell my students whenever these are the exact same to just substitute in. So it's the first thing you need to know is to substitute. So we're going to do that, and I'm going to say 2x plus 1 is equal to x squared plus 2x minus 8. Now we have to do the whole moving things around so that we can set it equal to 0 and find where the zeros would be when we solve this. So I'm going to move the 2x plus 1 all the way over to the other side. And your teachers may draw a line here for you so that you can see it, but all you're going to do is you're going to do the opposite. That's the inverse operation, and we're going to line them up. So this makes a 0, as will this. Just because they are the exact same. So I have a plus 1 is equal to x squared minus 8. Well, now I have to change and move this 1 over. So I'm going to take away the 1. And I have 0 is equal to x squared. A negative 8 plus or minus a 1 is a negative 9. Same sign, got to put them together. So minus 9. Now, your teacher may have said something to you about the difference of two squares. This is a perfect square, as is this. So since they're perfect squares, you have something times itself that will give you those. So that means I can factor this into two binomials. I know that x times x is x squared, so I'm going to put those in there. I also know that 3 times 3 is 9. Same number, so I can use that. Now, I have to have this become a negative. And the only way to do that with integers is a plus and a minus. So I've got to do one of each. And we set this whole thing equal to 0. And now, you know that anytime you multiply by 0, you get 0. So one of these two things has to equal 0. So you have to set each of them equal to the 0, and then just solve these one-step equations. So on this one, I'm going to take away on both sides. So I have x is equal to a negative 3. That's one answer. And then I'm going to add 3 over here. And I have x is equal to a positive 3. So my two answers for x is a negative 3 and a positive 3. But I believe if we go all the way back up here, this said x and y. So we have to find both. That means I have to plug my two x's, the 3 and the negative 3, in place of one of these and find what y would equal. Well, I don't like to work with x squared, so I'm not going to do that. So I'm going to go in and plug it into the 2x plus 1. So we're going to come over here. I have 2x plus 1 is equal to y. And we're going to do this twice. 2 times negative 3 plus 1. Well, 2 times negative 3 is negative 6. I'm going to add 1 to that. That means I'm at a negative 5. So my one point would be negative 3, negative 5. And now we have to do the other one. Oh, so let's pick a different color here. Y is equal to 2x plus 1. And we're going to plug in the positive 3, the other answer. So I have 2 times 3 plus 1. So I get 6 plus 1, so it equals 7. So y must be 7. Which means my second point is a positive 3, positive 7. So if you were to graph this to double check it on your calculator, the graphing calculator, these would be the two points where both of those different things, the quadratic and the line, would cross at negative 3, negative 5, and at 3, 7. I hope that helps, and please give us a call so we can help you with your homework.